The subtleties of devotion. Seeing to the comfort of Vaishnavas is our duty. Once Guru Maharaj organized a religious convention, Dharma Sabha, in Krishnanagar, and invited many of his godbrothers. Due to heavy rain, a leak in the ceiling developed in the room. Shri Srimad Bhakti Alok Paramhans Maharaj, a disciple of Srila Prabhupada, was staying, and so water had dripped all through the night. When Guru Maharaj came to know of this, he personally went to Srila Paramhans Maharaj's room, offered Dandavat Pranam, and very humbly sought forgiveness. "I am highly embarrassed by my inability to arrange suitable accommodations for you. Please be merciful and forgive me." Srila Paramhans Maharaj said, "Maharaj, I was awake well before the water began dripping from the ceiling. I was peacefully sitting inside my mosquito net and chanting Hari Nam. There is no need for you to feel distress." Guru Maharaj called for me and said, "The leak in the ceiling needs to be fixed immediately. Have it completed today. Please have it repaired nicely so that this problem does not reoccur. Our guests have come solely due to our invitation and not of their own impulse. We will therefore be at fault if they experience any discomfort. It is an offense if we do not make sincere efforts to serve the Vaishnavas. So it is our duty to make suitable arrangements to ensure that their stay here is comfortable." As per the instructions of Guru Maharaj, I had the entire roof covered with tin sheets, on top of which I placed bricks. As a result, not a single drop of rainwater dripped into the room. Personally and sincerely serving his godbrothers. Guru Maharaj used to invite his godbrothers to his mutts in Kolkata, Vrindavan, Chandigarh, and other places for the sake of preaching the message of Sri Rupa Raghunath. On all such occasions, Guru Maharaj would personally ensure that they had been provided with all the amenities required to make their stay comfortable. He would visit their room daily, offer pranam, and humbly inquire whether they were comfortable and if there was anything they needed. He would then call for their respective personal servants and give them full permission to take whatever they needed for the service of their Gurudev from the Bhandari, person in charge of supplies, without hesitation, be it milk, yogurt, or anything else. Do not be a miser in Vaishnav Seva. Shri Srimad Kunj Bihari Das Babaji Maharaj, a disciple of Srila Prabhupada, was once the mutt in charge of Sri Gaudiya Math branch in Cuttack. Later, he stayed in Braj and was always deeply absorbed in bhajan. He somehow maintained his life by performing Madhukari Viksha, begging small amounts of alms from many homes while visiting different parts of Braj Mandal. In his old age, he came to reside in Sri Vinod Vyani Gaudiya Math, a branch of Sri Chaitanya Gaudiya Math in Vrindavan. In those times, the mutt did not offer the best accommodations or facilities, and so Babaji Maharaj had to stay in a room with a ceiling made of asbestos panels. When Guru Maharaj visited Sri Vinod Vyani Gaudiya Math, he went to Babaji Maharaj's room, offered him pranam and asked, "Is our inability to offer you the best facilities a cause of concern or inconvenience for you?" Babaji Maharaj replied, "It is my habit to maintain myself through doing Madhukari Viksha, and here I am being served very nice prasad 3 times a day. I am accustomed to sleeping in kutirs, huts, dharamshalas, travelers' inns, and even under trees. Here, I have been provided with a separate room. How, then, can the question of inconvenience arise?" After this incident, Guru Maharaj told us, "Our service has only 2 objects, Vishnu and the Vaishnavas. Of the 2, service to the Vaishnavas is more important. Therefore, you should render service to the Vaishnavas carefully, without making any mistakes. I am not saying that you should offer opulent food to Babaji Maharaj, but rather you should serve him with the utmost sincerity and dignity, and use whatever resources are available to the greatest extent possible. Never act like a miser while offering honor and respect to the Vaishnavas, as it will only adversely affect your spiritual progress. The highest goal of Vaishnav conduct. After Srila Prabhupada's disappearance from this world, many of his renowned disciples who had dedicated their lives for his service used to gather every year on the day of Sri Jagannath Mahotsav, the day after Sri Gaur Purnim, at Sri Chaitanya Saraswat Math in Navdeep, which was established by Sri Srimad Bhakti Raksha Sridhar Gosai Maharaj. On one such occasion, I had the good fortune of witnessing a most astonishing example of the highest ideal of Vaishnav conduct. After honoring Mahaprasad, all the Vaishnavas went to take rest in their respective rooms in the mat. Srila Sridhar Gosami Maharaj, however, sat and rested on an easy chair outside his bhajan kutir, while his sevak, Sri Bhakti Sundar Govind Maharaj, took Guru Maharaj inside Srila Sridhar Gosami Maharaj bhajan kutir and requested him to take rest on Srila Sridhar Gosai Maharaj's bed. Guru Maharaj signaled Srila Govind Maharaj to lay a mat and pillow on the floor nearby. He then lay down and rested on the mat and not on Srila Sridhar Gosai Maharaj's bed. Srila Govind Maharaj told me, "The transcendental body of your Guru Maharaj and his attractive face made it appear as if he was a manifestation of Bhagwan himself." Later, Srila Sridhar Gosai Maharaj invited Guru Maharaj to sit on his easy chair, but Guru Maharaj declined. Srila Sridhar Gosai Maharaj said, "According to Var Varaner Nyai, that is, the logic of a groom on the day of his wedding, there is no fault if you accept my seat. Just as it is not considered disrespectful when a groom rides atop a mare during his wedding procession while his elders, like his father, grandfather, priests, and other relatives, walk on foot, there would be no consideration of offense if you were to sit in my easy chair." When Srila Sukadev Goswami accepted an elevated seat in the presence of his father, Sri Krishna Dwaipan Ved Vyas, his grandfather, Sri Parashar Muni, and great sages like Angira Rishi and Bhaguri Rishi, in order to narrate Srimad Bhagavatam to Parikshit Maharaj, his act of sitting high was completely free from any fault or offense. Similarly, there will be no fault or offense should you choose to accept a seat in my easy chair. Still, Guru Maharaj did not accept the seat. He said, "The conduct of a groom and that of Sri Sukadev Goswami is followed in the wake of some particular circumstance for the sake of service. Such conduct is not for general circumstances, and therefore it cannot be imbibed in one's regular day-to-day conduct. Imitating such conduct without discrimination will definitely be considered an offense." The etiquette and conduct Guru Maharaj demonstrated in front of his senior godbrother was ideal and ought to be followed by everyone. His eagerness to serve his godbrothers. Shripad Jagmohan Prabhu, a disciple of Srila Prabhupada, wrote a letter to both Sri Srimad Bhakti Kusum Shravan Goswami Maharaj and Guru Maharaj, expressing his desire to stay with either of them. In the letter to Guru Maharaj, he wrote, "I have heard you establish an institution in Kolkata named Sri Chaitanya Gaudiya Math. If you will allow, I wish to reside with you there. Kindly inform me about your decision and I will arrange accordingly." When Guru Maharaj read Sri Jagmohan Prabhu's letter, he replied immediately without any delay, "I have become highly inspired by hearing that you wish to come and bestow your mercy upon this wretched soul. I take this as an indication that Srila Prabhupada is still merciful to me. Please come to Kolkata as soon as you receive this letter." There was some delay in Sri Shravan Goswami Maharaj's reply, and so Guru Maharaj's letter was the first reply to reach Sri Jagmohan Prabhu. After a few days, Sri Jagmohan Prabhu wrote another letter. "I have heard that you are organizing Sri Braj Mandal Parikrama this year. I would like to perform Braj Mandal Parikrama with you, and after completing Parikrama, accompany you to Kolkata? Guru Maharaj replied, At the moment, we are still considering whether or not to perform Braj Mandal Parikrama this year. If and when it becomes confirmed, however, can you not accompany us from here in Kolkata via the coach that will be reserved for transporting all the devotees? Please do not deprive those of us in Kolkata of your kind association, for which we have developed a greed to attain. After receiving Guru Maharaj's letter, Sri Jagmohan Prabhu agreed to immediately go to Kolkata, and he informed Guru Maharaj of his itinerary. One day, Guru Maharaj called for me and said, Today my godbrother Sri Jagmohan Prabhu will arrive from Mathura at Howrah station. Go and receive him with great honor. Offer him pranam, chandan, sandalwood paste, and a flower garland and escort him here. Although he wears white cloth, he has remained celibate throughout his entire life. He will most certainly be adorned with bright Vaishnav tilak on his forehead. After confirming his identity, book a taxi and accompany him here. Do not bring him by bus or tram. Following the instructions of Guru Maharaj, I went to Howrah station to receive Sri Jagmohan Prabhu. The present system of reserving individual seats in a designated coach did not exist in those days, and I therefore searched for Sri Jagmohan Prabhu in each of the coaches one by one. Seeing a devotee dressed in white and adorned with Vaishnav tilak, I asked, Are you Jagmohan Prabhu? Without confirming his identity, he asked, Has Madha Mara sent you? I replied, Yes, and I offered him chandan, a flower garland, and pranam, took his luggage and belongings, booked a taxi, and accompanied him to the mutt. Guru Maharaj became extremely delighted upon meeting him. A proper approach can make us understand the heart of Vaishnavas. When Guru Maharaj announced in 1966 that camps would be set up at 18 different places during Braj Mandal Parikrama, that year his godbrother Sri Srimad Bhakti Surit Paramarthi Goswami Maharaj approached him and said, Maharaj, when Srila Prabhupada performed Sri Braj Mandal Parikrama, I served in the organizing party in the rear and was therefore unable to have proper darshan and hear the glories of all the pastime places in Braj. Now that you are organizing Braj Mandal Parikrama, it is my strong desire to take full advantage of this opportunity to visit the places where Sri Krishna performed his pastimes. However, I will only attend if you accept 50 rupees in Parikrama fees from me. Guru Maharaj replied, Vaishnavas are worshipful for us, and accepting fees from them is against my principles, especially after having invited them to take part in an event I am arranging. You are a Nishkinchan Vaishnav. You accept Krishna as your only wealth. Therefore, I cannot accept any Parikrama fees from you. Hearing Guru Maharaj's words, Srila Paramarthi Goswami Maharaj fell silent. As he was leaving Sri Chaitanya Gaudiya Math in Vrindavan to head towards Sri Govindji Mandir, I was approaching the mutt from the other side of the street. Seeing me, he said, Fate has not allowed me to perform Braj Mandal Parikrama. When I asked him why he felt that way, he explained everything. I asked him, Maharaj, why are you insistent upon giving 50 rupees? He replied, I am able to give 50 rupees, and so if I fail to give it, or if it is not accepted from me, then I will have committed an offense called vit shatya dosh, or being miserly with one's wealth. I told him, I will accept those 50 rupees from you. In this way, you will no longer be required to give them to Guru Maharaj, and Guru Maharaj will be spared accepting a fee from you, who are his worshipful object. What will you do with those 50 rupees? He asked. With this money, I replied, I will order rabadi. Footnote: A classical Indian sweet made by boiling condensed milk and sugar at some places during the parikrama and use it in the service of Sri Hari, Guru and Vaishnavas. He readily accepted my proposal and happily participated in the parikrama. When the parikrama reached Kamyavan, I took the money from him and arranged for 40 kilograms of rubbish to be distributed among all the pilgrims. Everyone honored that Rabri Prasad with great happiness. At that time, I loudly announced, Srimad Bhakti Surit Paramarthi Goswami Maharaj Ki Jai. Srila Paramarthi Goswami Maharaj later reprimanded me and asked, why did you take my name and advertise me as the donor of the Rabri Prasad? I replied, in using your name, I advertise my own purpose. How is that? He asked. I said, now that all the devotees have heard it was you who had donated the Rabri Prasad for the service of Sri Hari, Guru and Vaishnavas, some of them may enthusiastically come forward to perform a similar service, and thereby we will be able to overcome any financial difficulties that may stand in the way of our service. Srila Paramarthi Goswami Maharaj became pleased to hear this. My explanation later proved to be true. Many devotees daily came forward and gave me money to purchase many items for the service of Sri Hari, Guru and Vaishnavas. When I told Guru Maharaj what had transpired, he said, Sri Paramarthi Maharaj is a Nishkinchan Vaishnav. I do not want to accept parikrama fee from him. But he did not understand my mind. I would have readily accepted a monetary contribution from some other service. You have helped him understand this and have inspired him to participate in Brajmandal Parikrama. My heart is filled with joy because of this. But this was not the only service you performed. By loudly calling out his name, you have pleased me further because we will never retreat. Paschat Pada, in our efforts to loudly proclaim the glories of the Nishkinchan Vaishnavas. Vaishnav Seva and Guru Seva are non-different. Whenever Guru Maharaj would preach at various places, many disciples of Srila Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhant, Saraswati Thakur would also join him in order to give the common persons there an opportunity to attain their topmost welfare. When Guru Maharaj's householder disciples would come forward to offer cloths, donations and other items, Guru Maharaj would say, I am relatively young and will surely come here again in the future, whereas my godbrothers are senior to me both in age and in the realm of bhakti and may not visit this place again. Who knows whether or not you will attain the fortune of having their darshan and association again. You should therefore serve them by offering all these gifts to them and not me. Vaishnav Seva and Guru Seva are non-different. In remembering these words of Guru Maharaj, the following teaching repeatedly manifests in our heart. Amito Vaishnav e buddhi haile amani na habo ami partishta asi hriday dushive haibo nirayagami. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Kalyan Kalpataru, Uchchavas 2.8.2. If I develop the idea that I am a Vaishnav, then I will never become humble. My heart will become contaminated with a desire to receive honor from others, and I shall go to hell. Due to the influence of time and our great misfortune, the conduct Guru Maharaj followed and demonstrated in his day-to-day personal dealings is seen today only in a very few exceptional devotees. Nowadays, we mostly observe in others the opposite of the conduct and behavior he exemplified. All one's possessions are to be seen as instruments in Vaishnav Seva. After the construction of Sri Chaitanya Gaudiya Math was completed in Sridham Mayapur, many disciples of Srila Prabhupada, including Sri Srimad Bhakti Sarang Goswami Maharaj, Sri Srimad Bhakti Kamal Madhusudan Goswami Maharaj, Sri Srimad Bhakti Vichar Yayavar Goswami Maharaj, Sri Srimad Bhakti Saurabh Bhakti Sar Goswami Maharaj, Sri Srimad Bhakti Sharan Shant Goswami Maharaj, Sri Srimad Bhakti Alok Paramhans Maharaj and others acquired land in Ashodhyan and expressed their desire to stay in Sri Chaitanya Gaudiya Math while building their own respective maths. Guru Maharaj ordered me, whenever any of my godbrother visits Mayapur, he should stay in my room, Bhajan Kutir, and you should serve him with a standard greater than you would employ when serving me. Some of Guru Maharaj's above mentioned godbrothers agreed to stay in his bhajan kutir, while others, due to their possessing a mood of reverence towards him, declined his offer. In all situations, Guru Maharaj always considered everything in his possession as an instrument of Vaishnav Seva and not as an object for anyone's sense enjoyment. He was always wholeheartedly absorbed in the objective of serving and bringing pleasure to his godbrothers. A fair and expert mediator. Guru Maharaj's personal conduct, divine characteristics and pure, non-duplicitous affection were extraordinary. So much so that his senior godbrothers would request him to act as a mediator and prescribe a suitable solution whenever a disagreement would arise among them. This is visible in the following incidents. After Srila Prabhupada's departure, Srimad Bhakti Pragyan Keshav Goswami Maharaj, Srimad Bhakti Kamal Madhusudan Goswami Maharaj and Srimad Bhakti Alok Paramhansa Maharaj initially stayed together and preached the message of Srila Prabhupada. Srila Keshav Goswami Maharaj would accept disciples and Srila Madhusudan Goswami Maharaj and Srila Paramhansa Maharaj would preach under his guidance. It was due to the preaching of Srila Madhusudan Goswami Maharaj that Sri Bhakti Vedanta Trikram Maharaj and Sri Bhakti Vedanta Narayan Maharaj took shelter of Sri Keshav Goswami Maharaj. Later, some differences arose among them. Guru Maharaj was called to reconcile those differences and resolve the situation. After hearing each of their views, Guru Maharaj said, Sri Keshav Maharaj has many renounced disciples, and therefore it is better that Sri Devanand Gaudiya Math remains with him. Sri Madhusudan Maharaj should continue preaching from the math in Vardhaman, and later I will personally assist him in acquiring a plot of land in Mayapur and building a math there. Sri Paramhansa Maharaj should be given a sufficient amount of funds so that he can purchase land in Mayapur and continue his services most suitably. The solution Guru Maharaj proposed was readily accepted by all of them. Guru Maharaj inspired a lady devotee, Srimati Panna Ma, a disciple of Srila Keshav Goswami Maharaj, who had taken up the path of bhakti after hearing Harikatha from Srila Madhusudan Goswami Maharaj, to acquire land in Sridham Mayapur for Srila Madhusudan Goswami Maharaj, and, true to his word, personally assisted in the construction of Srila Madhusudan Goswami Maharaj Math to the furthest extent possible. Sri Srimad Bhakti Raksha Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, Sri Srimad Bhakti Shod Ashram Goswami Maharaj and Shripad Narasinghanand Prabhu also used to preach together. When, for various reasons, some differences arose between them, it was Guru Maharaj alone who helped them come to an amicable resolution. Although he was a junior godbrother, they all gave importance to his suggestions, and when an agreement was reached, they expressed their heartfelt gratitude to him. Sri Srimad Bhakti Sarang Goswami Maharaj had established an institution called Sri Gaudiya Sangha. The institution later faced many difficulties after Srila Goswami Maharaj's disappearance, and it was Guru Maharaj alone who resolved the issues. Rescuing a godbrother from a most grave situation. After Srila Prabhupada performed his aprakat lila, or his physical disappearance from this world, a dark period engulfed the Gaudiya Math. And one after another, many brahmacharis who had taken shelter of the lotus feet of Srila Prabhupada left the mutt and returned home. Somehow, Guru Maharaj brought some of these devotees back to the mutt. Among them, Sri Srimad Bhakti Kumud San Goswami Maharaj. Then, Sri Radha Raman Brahmachari was foremost. Guru Maharaj walked for a long distance to reach Sri Radha Raman Brahmachari's house. And when he finally reached there, he saw Sri Radharaman Brahmachari sitting in his wedding ceremony, about to get married. Guru Maharaj spoke to his father, Shripad Vaikunthanath Prabhu, who was also a disciple of Srila Prabhupada. You are a Vaishnava and a disciple of Srila Prabhupada. How could you allow your renowned son to get married? Why did you not stop him from doing this? Sri Vaikunthanath Prabhu replied, to the best of my ability, I have tried to persuade him not to get married. But I did not force him to remain a brahmachari, as he may thought I was not interested in handing over his inheritance to him, or that I had become bereft of all affection for him. Guru Maharaj said, "If you would kindly allow, I would like to try to stop him from getting married, and if possible, take him back to the mutt." Sri Vaikunthanath Prabhu said, "Certainly you can try. It will be a matter of great joy if you succeeded in doing so." After speaking with Sri Radharaman Prabhu, Guru Maharaj brought him along with him and left the wedded ceremony where the priestly duties were being performed by Sri Srimad Bhakti Bhudev Shroti Gosai Maharaj. Later, Guru Maharaj asked Sri Srimad Bhakti Vichar Yayavar Goswami Maharaj to award sannyas to Sri Radharaman Prabhu. Sri Srimad Bhakti Kumud San Goswami Maharaj would often mention, "It was Srila Bhakti Dait Madhav Goswami Maharaj alone and no one else who was highly merciful to me and rescued me from that most grave situation." Vaishnav Seva is our topmost priority. Sri Srimad Bhakti Deshik Acharya Goswami Maharaj, a disciple of Srila Prabhupada, who had accepted sannyas from Sri Srimad Bhakti Rakshar Siddha Goswami Maharaj, stayed for the most of his life in Braj at Sri Kamai Karela, the appearance place of Sri Vishakha Sakhi. He once became somewhat sick and mentioned in a letter to Guru Maharaj that he needed 50 rupees in order to purchase medicine. In those days, Guru Maharaj resided with a few other devotees in a rented apartment on Ras Vihari Avenue in Kolkata. Whatever rice they collected through performing bhiksha, begging alms, was sold in order to purchase various essential items for the mutt. Sri Sankarshan Prabhu, a resident of Ranaghat, had donated a few brass cooking utensils, and somehow or other, the affairs of the mutt were being managed. When Guru Maharaj read the letter from Sri Acharya Goswami Maharaj, tears flowed from his eyes as he considered, "Although our situation is dire, it is my duty to serve my dear godbrother in his time of need." While pacing in his room, he devised a way to raise such a large sum of money. Eventually, he ordered me to call for his godbrother, Shripad Udharan Prabhu. When Shripad Udharan Prabhu came before Guru Maharaj, Guru Maharaj requested him, "Could you please kindly ask the shop owner who purchases the rice we collect in bhiksha for a loan of 50 rupees? Tell him we will repay the loan as soon as possible by collecting much larger quantities of rice. In case you are unable to procure a loan of 50 rupees from him, then accept whatever he gives you and try to collect the balance from the house of Sri Govind Babu. We have received an opportunity to serve a Vaishnav, and it is our duty to act on this opportunity right away. Serving our godbrother is our topmost priority, especially during this time when he so desperately needs help." Shripad Udharan Prabhu collected a loan of 30 rupees from the shop owner and 20 rupees from Sri Govind Babu's wife. It was only when he handed over these 50 rupees to Guru Maharaj that Guru Maharaj felt relief. Guru Maharaj then said to me, "Go to the Lake Market post office at once and send a telegram money order to Sri Bhakti Deshik Acharya Maharaj. Do not delay for even a moment." I left immediately and sent the money order. When I came back and informed Guru Maharaj, he said nothing, but his expressions communicated his gratitude as if he had performed some great favor to him. Serving the Vaishnavas without delay. Once, when Guru Maharaj was honoring Prasad right before leaving for Vrindavan from Kolkata, I read a letter to him that had just arrived from his godbrother, Sri Srimad Bhakti Deshik Acharya Goswami Maharaj. It read, "I need a medicine called Sadhana for my eyes. It is not available anywhere in Braj, so please bring it with you from Dhaka Pharmacy in Kolkata." Guru Maharaj immediately gave me his train and coach number and told me, "Take some money, purchase the medicine and proceed directly to Howrah train station. If I were to wait for you here in the mud, I would miss my train. I will therefore meet you at the train station in my coach." When I reached Dhaka Pharmacy, the shopkeeper had just opened the shop and was sweeping the floor. After hearing my request, he quickly finished his sweeping, but said he would help me only after he had offered incense and aarti to the deities in his shop. I am unable to describe the agony I suffered upon learning there would be a delay. I could not wait until he had completed his morning rituals. After finally procuring the medicine, I reached Howrah station and saw the green light had already been given and the train was just about to leave the platform. I kicked off my wooden sandals and ran as fast as I possibly could toward Guru Maharaj coach, as if I was racing to win a gold medal. When I got closer to Guru Maharaj coach, I saw him leaning out of his door of the coach, awaiting the arrival of his godbrother's medicine. Just as I handed over the medicine to Guru Maharaj, the train began to pull out of the station and he said, "We are fortunate to have taken advantage of this opportunity to perform Vaishnav Seva. Miserliness has no place in the service of Vishnu and Vaishnav." A very poor Grastha disciple of Srila Prabhupada would daily come to our mutt to honor Prasad. One day, after lunch Prasad, when all the residents of the mutt were resting, Guru Maharaj told me, "Quietly go to the storeroom and fill this Prabhu's bag with rice. Make sure no one comes to know of this. Certainly, no one would stop me from giving anything to anyone, nor would they mention such an incident to anyone outside the mutt. But if anyone were to harbor any ill feelings about this devotee and think him to be in any way inferior, then that person would be committing an offense. It is only to safeguard against such a regrettable offense that I am having it done discreetly. At times, Srila Prabhupada tests my inclination to serve the Vaishnavas by presenting before me the apparent underprivileged state of some of his disciples. Therefore, I always remain careful never to fail such an examination. We should always remain very careful in our attempts to assess the character of Vaishnavas. We must never neglect or dishonor them under any circumstances. We have renounced the world for the sole purpose of serving Sri Vishnu and the Vaishnavas. The only key to our success is to never act miserly while serving them. Providing shelter to a godbrother. After the disappearance of Srila Prabhupada, one of his disciples, Shripad Thakur Das Prabhu, began staying in Sri Bagh Bazar Gaudiya Math's branch in Mumbai. When he began performing sickness pastime in his old age, the Math authorities told him, "We are not in a position to take any further responsibility for you." Sri Thakur Das Prabhu thus left for Vrindavan, where he stayed in a rented room near Sri Gopeshwar Mahadev. A devotee from Mumbai used to send a monthly donation to him. I, too, was in Vrindavan in those days, engaged in the service of constructing a branch of Sri Chaitanya Gaudiya Math. One day, a devotee informed me that Sri Thakur Das Prabhu fell down the stairs after experiencing dizziness. I immediately sent my godbrother, Sri Veer Bhadur Prabhu, who had him admitted to Sri Ramakrishna Mission Hospital. When news of this incident reached Guru Maharaj, he sent a letter to me in which he wrote, "Sri Thakur Das Prabhu has rendered immense service to Srila Prabhupada. As per the instruction of Srila Prabhupada, he preached together with Sri Bhakti Sarvas Giri Maharaj. He used to play mridanga and perform very sweet kirtan. Ensure that he receives good care and does not experience any discomfort. Bring him to Sri Chaitanya Gaudiya Math upon his discharge from the hospital. We will gladly assume the responsibility of serving him for the rest of his life." Following Guru Maharaj's instructions, I brought Sri Thakur Das Prabhu to our mutt after his discharge from the hospital and he stayed with us for the rest of his life. The recipient of his godbrother's trust. Sometime after Guru Maharaj's disappearance from the vision of this world, Shripad Girendra Govardhan Prabhu, a disciple of Srila Prabhupada, was forced to take shelter in the house of one of his disciples because he had no personal assistants to serve him. Once, while speaking about Sri Girendra Govardhan Prabhu, Srila Bhakti Saurabh Paramarthi Goswami Maharaj, another disciple of Srila Prabhupada, sorrowfully and tearfully said, "If Sri Madhav Maharaj had still been physically present in this world, Sri Garendra Govardhan Prabhu would not have been forced to stay in the house of his disciple, because Sri Madhav Maharaj would have certainly arranged for him to stay in his mutt under the care of his disciples." This incident demonstrates the grief Guru Maharaj's godbrothers experienced after his departure and the great trust they had for him to look after the well-being of their other godbrothers. Remembering, honoring, and serving his godbrothers on their appearance days. One day Guru Maharaj called me into his room and handed me flowers, fruits, sweets, a set of saffron-colored cloths, and an envelope containing pranami, and ordered, "Go and give these things to Sri Bhakti Pramod Puri Maharaj and offer pranam to him with the utmost devotion. Offer pranam on my behalf as well. I am sending you because he may be hesitant to accept these items if I were to personally offer them." According to Guru Maharaj's order, I went to Srila Bhakti Pramod Puri Gosai Maharaj's room, offered pranam, offered him the items given by Guru Maharaj, and then relayed the message that Guru Maharaj also offers his pranam. Srila Bhakti Pramod Puri Gosai Maharaj laughingly said, "According to the Tithi, today is my birthday. All this is for me on my birthday. Madhav Maharaj remembered my birthday, even though he is so busy. This was the first time I came to know about the date of Srila Puri Gosai Maharaj's appearance day, Avirbhav Tithi." In this way, Guru Maharaj initiated the practice of honoring the appearance day of his dear godbrother. When I returned to Guru Maharaj and informed him that I had given everything to Srila Puri Gosai Maharaj, he said, "One should worship the Vaishnavas on their appearance days by remembering and serving them. We should hear the glorification, kirtan of their most sublime qualities and divine character. Because Srila Puri Maharaj is my senior godbrother, I have taken a room directly below his, so that I may always honor him by keeping him on my head and thus receive the shelter of his lotus feet. Only Sri Madhav Maharaj can resolve this issue." Sri Srimad Bhakti Rakshar Srida Gosai Maharaj had great affection and honor for Guru Maharaj, which was evident whenever they would meet together. Once, a female disciple of Srila Sridhar Gosai Maharaj donated to her Gurudev a piece of land in Barashahat in the north 24 Parganas district of West Bengal, and a few of his renunciate disciples started residing there. The relatives of that disciple filed a complaint with the local police against Srila Sridhar Gosai Maharaj disciples who were staying there. As a result of the complaint, they were held in the local police station. Upon hearing this news, Srila Sridhar Gosai Maharaj sent his sannyas disciple Sri Bhakti Sundar Govind Maharaj to Guru Maharaj with the message, "Only Sri Madhav Maharaj can resolve this issue." After Sri Bhakti Sundar Govind Maharaj related the details of incident to Guru Maharaj, Guru Maharaj immediately dropped everything and headed to the office of the deputy superintendent of police, who was the son-in-law of a disciple of Srila Prabhupada. After Guru Maharaj told him everything, he said, "I have not come here to take advantage of your position by seeking an unjust favor. I do, however, request you to carefully check the registration documents for the property and accordingly decide which of the two parties is right as per the law." The deputy superintendent then thoroughly checked all the documents. He helped the renunciants in every way and eventually got them released from jail. Guru Maharaj was always eager and ready to serve Srila Prabhupada and those connected to Srila Prabhupada. He was always extremely delighted and grateful whenever he received an opportunity to serve them. Duty extends beyond death. One day, Sri Srimad Bhakti Shovan Padmanabha Goswami Maharaj, a disciple of Srila Prabhupada, told Guru Maharaj, "I have established a small mutt between Kolkata and Puri at a place called Mecheda Junction. I wish to hand over its ownership to you and reside in any of your branches of Sri Chaitanya Gaudiya Mutt. Guru Maharaj replied, "He would be delighted to have you stay in any of our mutts and would be greatly fortunate to have you. We will serve you in all ways to the best of our ability. However, I sincerely request you not to hand over the ownership of your mutt to me in your will. In the event that I leave my body before you, you will be dependent upon my disciples to care for you, as you will be left bereft of any property or funds should you leave everything to me. If at that time those disciples of mine are unable to properly serve you with due respect, then I'll be guilty of not fulfilling my commitment to you."